Camouflaged columns advance to within sight of the city. And go into action. Gathering behind a railroad track, establishing protecting fire, the Germans capture the railroad leading into the city. Advanced tanks enter the outskirts of the already blazing city. While foot soldiers penetrate with machine guns and automatic rifles. Relentlessly, the German troops thread their way into the city, carrying machine guns and light cannons with them. Proceeding cautiously through the rubble and debris of the blasted city, hiding behind every wall, taking fullest possible advantage of cover, the soldiers move toward the center of the city. A nest of snipers is discovered in a ruined building. And the Germans move methodically forward to wipe them out. Surprised and captured, the stubborn defenders emerge from their hideout, hands up. With one half the city taken, the Germans bring up a loudspeaker system, over which they warn the still resisting Russian defenders that further resistance will mean death. Surrender before it's too late. Surrender before it's too late. Resisting to the last, the Russians burn their city before they leave. Scorched earth and ruins. Leaving to the conquerors few valuable spoils of victory. Only a few tanks, large and small, obsolete cannon supplies, which could not be carried away, fall to the hands of the Germans. Prisoners. Prisoners of war, marching to internment camps. Skilled and clever Nazi interrogators grill the prisoners for information as to direction of the Russian withdrawal. The German chiefs go over change of plans in their new advance. A change based on information gained from talkative prisoners. The troops quickly move out toward the discovered hideout of retreating Russians. While aircraft, guided by information from loose-tongued prisoners, aim directly for a cleverly concealed Russian bivouac and supply area. Strafing, bombing, the Germans attack heavily. Patrolling alone, a German light bomber catches a Russian supply train unloading at a depot, hitting at its target time after time as it dives. Circling lazily, the German closes in for another assault, this time with cannon. leaving the train wrecked and in ruins. Another vital Russian position destroyed. Vast German offensive sweeps closer to Leningrad. Attacking by night, another important Russian city, across a broad river from the German attackers. Spitting fire as they advance, tanks forge through the night. While flashing artillery pours shells into the city across the river. Chaos. Destruction, war. Dawn, with artillery still pounding the opposite shore, protecting the early morning advance of assault troops who crossed the river in outboard propelled craft. Note the unusual length of the propeller shaft. Pursuit and bomber planes aid in the assault. Infantry shock troops line the shore, waiting to cross the river in a captured river steamer. The city taken, German gunners establish protection for the advance of engineers who repair the demolished bridges. Gambling on taking Moscow by early fall, the Germans had timed their attack to take full advantage of the summer weather. But they had not counted on savage Russian resistance. And by September came fall rain. Slowing the Nazi advance. Wind and rain heralded the approach of Russian winter. Bogged down German mechanization proved that, like anyone else, the Germans could be stopped and defeated.